Growing up in Britain, I know that I'm enormously privileged, free to make choices, to state opinions, to be independent. But for many of the world's women, perhaps the majority, circumstances are very different. So in this series, I'm travelling to three very different communities where the roles of women are exceptional, complex, and even extreme. The Kuria tribe in Kenya, where women are caught up in the clash between age-old traditions and the modern world.
How do you go and find a man?
The intensely private, ultra-Orthodox Haredim in Israel, who live by strict religious laws. Now, I'm in northeast India.
Hello.
Hi, Chitu.
Kate.
With the Khasi people and their extraordinary matrilineal system. That puts women at the forefront of society.
You're like a very strict headmistress.
Disciplinary job.
Over the last decade, India has been ranked as one of the worst countries in the world to be a woman. So this is the last place you'd expect to find women in charge.
So if you need money, do you have to ask Shito for that money?
But can this ancient way of life survive as India continues to modernize?
Gosh, that's quite a chink in your matrilineal utopian system, isn't it?
Yes, not so utopian.
I'm in the city of Shillong, the capital of Meghalaya State in northeast India. Meghalaya's a beautiful place, full of deep gorges and steep, forested hills, often shrouded in mist.
India is one of the hardest places to be female. Inequality is absolutely ingrained in society. Domestic violence is rife. Child marriage is common. Arranged marriages, of course, are the norm.
But in this remote corner of India, the local Khasi people, who number around 1.75 million, practice a matrilineal way of life where everything, including property and the family name, is passed down the female line. It's believed that this female-led way of life was once practiced by 30% of the world's population. But now, there are just a handful of communities left. I want to know how it works in this part of India.
Does a matrilineal system allow women to, I don't know, choose their own husbands or choose how many children to have? Does it allow them to have businesses and to be entrepreneurs? All the things that I don't connect, rightly or wrongly, with India.
I want to find a community where this exceptional system is working as it always has. So I've been told to head up into the hills. It's a 4-hour drive to my destination, a small village literally at the end of the road. Kong Thong is a settlement of 500 people and one of the 12 villages that make up the core of Meghalaya's matrilineal system. Hi. The history of this culture has only survived by oral tradition, so pinning down its origins is hard. But it's said that it started when Kasi men went off to fight wars. They'd be gone for years, and many wouldn't return. So the women took over managing the family wealth and became responsible for the vital continuity of bloodlines by passing on the female family name. I'm staying with the Kongsit clan, who've lived here for generations.
Hi.
And I've been told that a woman called Shitor is the most important family member.
Hello.
Hi, Shitor. Kate, lovely to meet you. Thank you very much for letting me come and see you today.
Shitor is the cat door. The head of the family.
So is this all your family here?
But what's unusual in Kasi society is that the cat door is also the youngest daughter.
Hello, I'm Kate. Hi. So is this your husband? Yeah? This is your good man. Very nice to meet you. Is it Balung? Mm. Balung. Nice to meet you.
Shitor and Balung have been married for 30 years.
Okay, now tell me who everyone else is.
They have 7 children, 5 girls and 2 boys. Hello.
And so this is your youngest daughter?
12-year-old Habashisha is the next generation cat door.
You're the cat door, so you're going to be in charge.
In Kasi society, unlike the rest of India, the birth of a daughter is vital to continue the family line. And it's the youngest daughter who holds this important role as the one most likely to marry last and therefore most able to take care of her aging parents.
So, can you tell me about your family? And when your parents died, did your brother and sister inherit anything at all, or did absolutely everything come to you? It sounds like that's the best thing to be the youngest daughter. But actually, there's a very big responsibility on the shoulders of the cat door. Do you sometimes wish that you hadn't been the youngest daughter? And you, down there, can you tell me what your duties are as this very important member of the family? We're camping in the village. It's a world away from the hubbub and car horns of modern Shillong. And already, I feel myself relaxing into the pace of life here. And you get the feeling that there are these sort of little pockets of humanity that kind of exist almost in isolation, tucked in these beautiful hills. I mean, it's the most staggeringly dramatic landscape.
Sim kata kau wait. Wait pamang kata. Ah ne.
This way? Or this way? Down here?
Shittors asked me to help with the harvest from their forest garden down in the valley.
Hello!
Most of the villagers here rely on agriculture to make a living, harvesting oranges, wild bay, and pepper.
I keep like that. Is there a system here for people to communicate with each other?
Can you get a come right by Dunny Pralok, nay, Bahaying, by Dun Shakaweka, Jaka? Matade, Kirwad, getting right, a snail, yeah.
Do you have a family song? So if you're trying to call your daughters, will they know it's you? Will you call this daughter here? That's lovely. And so for each one of your children, do they all have a different song? Each one.
Finally, after a three-hour descent, we arrive at the wild pepper fields.
Did you find pepper already? Look at that. Wow. So this is a very important crop for you. Well done. Brilliant. Suddenly, when you get your eye in, it's everywhere.
I haven't heard anything yet from Ba Lung about how men fit into this system, because it's the women who manage all the family's finances on a day-to-day basis.
So if you need money to buy a new machete or a new pair of shoes, do you have to ask Shito for that money? Does that ever bother you? I mean, you're working as hard as she is.
One issue that would certainly cause a disagreement in most societies is that the children here inherit the mother's surname rather than the father's. For many men, especially here in India, this would surely be a step too far. Lung seems not only to accept the Kasi way, but actually to be happy that his wife holds the purse strings and that it's her name that's passed on to their children. There's a real sense of kind of identity, I think. He's such a deeply respectful man. Respectful of his family, respectful of his wife, but more than anything, respectful of the culture that he comes from. And absolutely feels that upholding the matrilineal tradition is right at the heart of what it means to be Kasi. This is the dry season. Nothing dry about it. I'm fascinated by the dynamic between men and women here, and in a way, it's the men's role that I'm finding the most difficult to understand. But whereas the husband of the Kakdur doesn't seem to have much of a say in family matters, there are men in the community who do have influence. Ba Lung's brother-in-law is Ba Bring, one of Kong Thong's soothsayers. Whilst much of India is predominantly Hindu, the majority of Kasis have embraced Christianity. But they also still practice their own religion, Ka Nyam Kasi. Soothsayers claim to read signs contained in eggs and animal entrails and be able to help the sick. Ba Bring's seeking approval from the Kasi god, Yu Blei, about the appointment of a new village elder. I'm slightly disappointed to see no women involved in this practice. Like tribal councils the world over, there are only men here responsible for the community's administration. The soothsayer's wife is Shidiap, Shittor's elder sister. When you have these prayers, it's only men. I'm surprised by that in a society that values women so much. Overall, the Kasi system does seem to be harmonious in its sharing of duties between men and women.
Okay.
There are clear roles here based on ancient traditions. Kasi men still claim responsibility for politics and administration, but women work alongside them in the fields.
Okay. Yep.
And they're in charge of the family finances and property. They're the sustaining force of the family lineage as guardians of the surname.
Right. I'm ready. I'll race you up the hill.
It seems so far this is a great place to be a woman. Before I leave Kon Thong, Ba Bring, Ba Lung, and some of their friends are taking me on a final trek down into the valley. They're on their way to repair a bridge.
Oh my goodness! Look at that! Wow!
Wow, what a piece of architecture.
I think that's the most beautiful bridge I've ever seen.
This is a traditional living root bridge, made out of the roots of two rubber trees that have been trained over the centuries to grow across the river below.
How safe is it? Oh my God! It's quite scary! My heart's going like the clappers! It's like a sort of giant basket work up here.
Tasaka kalong kalong kami man yu ndakala he tolong bat ni
yo bat lang.
The bridge once provided a vital trade link to neighboring villages, but today business relies on the many roads that have been constructed across these hills.
What a beautiful thing though. Amazing.
As the modern world creeps ever closer, I'm keen to know what these men think the future holds for their unusual way of life.
Balong maki kaya kendu bat isiam mesi bun jaki brio. Bagi asiam kentu te hadir. Te hakijing mudi berkat yang ti si kekalan lah bagi kwa lang ya kata ya bagi pek ikan ujoy kiwai pati jaki benrio, kiwai pati jaka.
Ngal ngawan naka pateng ke bah kenjain naka kumi. Dah ngai pat haki kun pilih pai kelaman sekaja jumpa jadi sengel terkalong kala prabha kerukum kerukum ngek kerukum berkat aku pergi ada ka kakul ka jai normal
bal nasinya ba kan ni kajing ai jadi kemir kelenjonga kebangi dang deh hiban penne
dan lai tang man supen kala di kemon breu kem kemon bele kan la
It does feel like you're in the presence of a really equal society. And that's so rare. So to me, it feels really precious. It doesn't feel like an antiquated, outdated system. It feels very current, very timely. The big unanswered and at the moment unanswerable question is that although the matrilineal system seems absolutely unshakable and rock solid, now is the time that the first generation of young people from this village are going and getting a broader education. And that, I think, is going to be the thing that will really potentially throw out of balance this seemingly quite utopian way of living. I'm back in Shillong, 40 miles and a world away from the village. Shillong was once a British hill station at the time of the Raj. Today, it's a hub for education and is embracing Western culture. Two-thirds of the population here is Khasi. It does feel different from much of India. Women can hang out with men without stigma. They can enjoy social mobility as there's no caste system. And there's no system of dowry or arranged marriage. This is Yodu Market, and here it's the women who run most of the stalls. From owning small shops to large businesses, from teaching to being a doctor, Kasi culture allows women to aspire to pursue careers. I've been told there's a woman here, a Kat Dur, who's fulfilling a role most people would assume is very much a man's job. Dwilifor Mangar is a police inspector.
Where's Ram? Khaki vardi chhon liya, din ya raat jab kam hone se, bolane se, korne porta hai. Flying, Romeo One.
The inspector's in charge of one of the largest of Shillong's seven traffic districts. And she's taking me out on patrol.
You're like a very strict headmistress.
Disciplinary job.
To become the head of this department as a woman, do you think had to work harder than your male counterparts to prove that you were capable of the job?
Kibalong matrilineal society ngi khan kum jo chen rang kan thai te ngi trai lang bat ngi sngau tanat lang tang na ka banta ka jing bet jing biang jong ka kam hi ngim don ka jing sau ya phar jing mon.
As dusk falls and rush hour arrives,
up.
The traffic gets even busier.
Kloy arsaka hangtel arsaka hangte banian arsaka banian ngte se hoy bas ban thet jing thet kan banian ka jaka ka bala dai ba ai banian
namar ladangam don hakane ka society tharai nganom la bangan long kum ne ko manga long manta hanrei de nagane hi ba ka snam jong ngi hi la don ka jing 3 minute ka jing 3 sitom kirukan thairo kilong barab kilong kumju wat kirang ba
wan klam ka ne ka wei ka bai kha ne hajam no parking persa ka lat ban lai one store
hoi ka ta te mdon jing arta ten na ka ne ka jing long jing em jong ki khasi jong ngi hi ka ba pan la yang ngi kum ki kan thai.
Like many Khasi women, the inspector balances her career with her responsibilities as a Kat Dur and as a mother.
Aga por banga dang long kum sub inspector. Ngahap sim sibun kikes. Bun sin banga ba yu kun ubarit hang ni hamet. Bat nga thok kis diri. Man kamit. Ngam jutia, ngatia ar kenta. Lanilai kenta.
Did you have support from your husband, your family? Did they help you look after the children?
Ngam dan setia ka jeng kersan na u kabun kawan si sha tang ka jeng sha le ben tang ka jeng sha karan ben.
What do you mean by that?
Bun sen ba hab what happen let the sick leave namar ba usho udat ban la sho ban yang ro tang tang kadon ka por le ka ba hapor ba dang armet hapor banga dang expect ki iba ar te hapor ba tu sho ukun jat yang ana sa ne bro kan te ngana mut balas ne yo ma shu pet ruma sorry. Tenda layat kisngi ki banai pada nga yo pada da kon kan thai ke kon ba ar de kon kan thai na mar ba e long i ba don bok mo pada nga sak kemen kan ba bat sabo ai kerteng I lucky Mary ro ba.
Despite the abuse, the inspector stayed with her husband and had two more children.
Namar ngam ya thuk ka ta condition ngong bai bang aur. Namar bang as ngol ranya ka pertai ban ya thuk ba nga sha sho a ulo. Hole ul snu uk pa ki khon genom so thiet rai em nga sngau ba. Ki khon jong a la da dai bu sha uk pa ban sha kem ta ka mot ba. Ki khon jong a ro ken ken le ran la sha le chi singi. Hado bang anda be san don ye una yang.
Do you think your husband was somehow jealous that you were doing well in your professional life? And also, because as you say, you were the cat door, you were the person who owned the property.
Ipa ila penang pen start yang I ngadon ka kam ka jam. Kenang bu unyo bej ban supendon kam bakla bej ki e ki e hendrai. Ukua bej tang bangan kamai ngan ayah u. Hendrai ki e ki e baru ki bombet bombet yang sudah nak bentajau u namar. Ngidai nak matrilineal society. Penlak si bun hi kain bangian perkat ba. Lada de bangi divorce ro. Kibun hi ki reu kentai ki bakum nga ki balong ki single mother.
Finally, the inspector did divorce her husband. We tried to contact him to get his side of the story, but were unable to track him down.
Do you or your children have any contact with your husband at all anymore?
But ha ei udon ro ngim tip. Ki khun jong ngim tip. Karang biang kata sibon.
India has been cited as one of the most dangerous countries to be a woman, and domestic abuse is widespread. But at least here in Meghalaya, women like the inspector can stand up to their abusers and can divorce, which would be unthinkable for many women in the rest of India.
The inspector is... she's a remarkable woman. To come out of that situation intact, and not just intact, but a woman with an extraordinary career. That's pretty astounding.
I come to come out back, come to come out.
And seeing her out here, I mean, I don't know what constitutes a traffic violation in Shillong. Everything looks like a traffic violation to me. But she fiercely marches into the traffic like Boadicea and sorts everybody out.
Abrasta ka bis me khara korke ekdam susta nei dusra lokaliye bi.
Although the inspector's story is shocking, her education, job and independent wealth have allowed her to recover and bring up her family. But what happens to Khasi women who haven't been educated or who don't have family wealth behind them? The inspector told me there are many single mothers in Shillong. And just like in the rest of India, in Meghalaya state, despite the matrilineal system, there's been a rise in crimes against women. So I'm meeting Dala Nung Puyur, a Katdur, a mother, and a career woman, who's going to help me understand what's causing this growing problem.
Well, you know, like for a man to leave his wife and children, go on to another woman, have children there, and maybe move on to a third woman, that happens as well.
Mm-hmm.
There is definitely a very high number of single mothers here.
Mm-hmm.
It's more common for Khasi couples to cohabit rather than marry. So, it's all too easy for the men just to walk away, with no sense of responsibility for the children who bear their mother's family name.
But is there no law or system to make those men pay some sort of support for their children?
Okay, this is where it gets a little complicated. Because of the matrilineal system, the children belongs to the mother, to the mother's
and
family,
they take the mother's name, don't they?
They take the mother's name.
Yeah.
And so some men have claimed that we don't have a right to even to our own children. And so they kind of feel free to just leave them. And there is a law, of course, that a man has to pay a certain amount of maintenance.
Yeah.
But a lot of women do not claim that.
Presumably, if they're educated and they can have good jobs like the inspector, it's not necessarily a problem. There's no stigma to being a single mother, is there?
There is no stigma, but not all women are educated. Not all women are well off enough. And a lot of them feel a certain amount of shame in asking from the father to actually go to a man who has abandoned you and ask for money from him. Yeah. To some of them, it amounts to begging. A lot of them would go as domestic help. That right. is one thing, you know, where they go wash clothes or they go clean up the house for the other more well-to-do families. Yeah. And I also know of girls who have entered sex work as an option to feed their family.
Gosh, that's quite a chink in your matrilineal utopian system, isn't it?
Yes, not so utopian.
Yeah. Wow.
So we go down there.
Dulla's taking me to meet a group of single mothers who've had to resort to sex work to survive.
Just go ahead, go ahead. Yeah, yeah. No, just 20 meters before them. Stop.
According to a charity that works with these women in Shillong, of the 408 active sex workers here, 320 are single mothers.
Why did you end up working as a prostitute?
I'm the youngest of six. I'm the gaddo. My father passed away.
They've asked to be kept anonymous, and we've changed their voices.
And then my mother got ill, so I had to drop out of school and return home. But then my husband left me when I was pregnant.
Do you think that there's anything about Kasi society, perhaps the matrilineal system, that makes men feel that they're allowed to just walk away from their responsibilities?
It's the men who are at fault in most of these cases. If they actually took proper care of us, we wouldn't have to do this.
I did other jobs like making street food, working till 1 o'clock in the morning. But then I had to get up at 6 in the morning to get my child ready for school. But it was just too exhausting. I can't get a proper job. This is my only option.
You're all Kasi women. You come from a very ancient tradition. Would any of you like to see it change?
I think things need to change. Let the men bear more responsibility. Maybe the children can take their father's surname. If they had his surname, I think he'd be around a lot more. It is the husband's duty to support the family, even if he leaves.
Men come and live with us, but when they see we're not well off, they feel they have more freedom to walk all over us.
These are tragic stories, and to be honest, not what I expected from what I thought was such an equal society. But it seems that the system here is disenfranchising men, and that's having a serious impact on both sexes.
The problem with the caste society, where the women are right up there and the men are way down, this little gap is increasing day by day, and it scares the wits out of us.
Keith Parriott set up a men's campaign group in 1990. It has a membership of 4,000, and has often been compared to a male suffragette movement.
The custom has given everything to the women. They've given property to the women. They've given the title of the children to the women.
Are you saying that because Kasi society has this matrilineal system, men are feeling increasingly inferior to women?
Kasi men feel absolutely unwanted. They feel absolutely useless in society. We do feel inadequate.
Right.
When we compare ourselves to the women.
Mm.
There are males dropping out from school, male students. There are males who are into drugs and alcohol. The males have no responsibility on their shoulders.
What's wrong with Kasi men? Don't they need to just grow a backbone?
Well, I would say yes. But the system has been bearing down on them for so long that they've lost their backbone. I would ideally love a system that gives importance to both men and women.
Right.
Okay. Our attempt to bring a change is not that we hate women. It's not that we want to be ahead of them. Not that we want to be the leaders and they the followers. No. We want to pick the men up from the gutter where they are so that they become more respectable as people.
Unlike up in the villages, so many relationships here in Shillong seem to be fracturing. Clearly men are struggling, but is it really the Kasi tradition that's at fault? Krau Brock Shudup was happily married to a Kapdor for 14 years. But recently, things have started to go wrong for him, his wife, and their four children.
Hakiniki sedang senem gumtu kadan kencing sitom di kiau. Wanda sitom kiau gumtu te ilok jangai hap nik pe sti nama robai di kadu. Te hadi nang tu anabi kiau ilak kam klan tu. Te kal adon ga kubor ba. Nama robai di kadu kan hap syong hap sa no sini. Kan hap pe iki ngas sem gum de gum tai.
Krau's wife had to fulfill her duties as the youngest daughter and move away from Shillong, back to her family home.
So, effectively, your wife, because she's the Kapdor, was forced to make a decision. She had to choose either her duty as a Kapdor or to abandon that duty and keep her marriage alive, but she wasn't able to do both.
That's all true. Kaya iban perkara kita. Nawa bide kadu. Tadi nata kadang masa ailat irung orang ato. Kum usen rangi. Kalau nggak siam jeng iya lah dangim dan kakam kajam nala dia.
It took Krau many years to get his job as a porter in one of Shillong's busiest hospitals. A state job like this, although not well paid, gives him a sense of pride.
But as a Kasi man, you presumably knew that by marrying a Kapdor, this situation was probably going to arise at some point.
กะเรกะกัมกะวะเอคัมตัมเลดิฮะบังยะคันดุชงคากัมฮะกะลงเยียงกะบะกะตะกะลงเยียงรุกะบุนกิติคอนเต็งๆนะวะบะฮะกะฮะกะเยียงคัดดุกะเยียงคัดดุกะดิกะเยียงกะบะบะรอบะรอยะรุงยะมิลุดบัดกะเยียงกะดิกะบะคัดบวนตึนรุชิวจาอุทคานอุนชิมกะเปลี่ยงอุนบามดอนอิวดอนอิวตัวเต็งกะปัดกะมละบันทีดิตากะนุมกัดยะตะกะยิงดอนกะยิงกีละเนตะกะยิงอังนุดกะยิงกี
And then an unexpected guest arrives.
He done there. Hey, done.
Yeah? So is it his wife has come with one of the kids?
Huh?
Hello there. Hello. Lovely to meet you.
It would be really interesting to have your point of view as well, but obviously only if you had time and you were happy to talk to me.
lagi habanya tu nak ada yang jaga jing snow jong kini nak jaga.
Do you feel that as the cat door, you were put in an almost an unfair situation? So when Crow made his decision to stay in Shillong and not come and live with you in your mother's house, what did you think? Did you understand his decision? Do you think he has let you down? And would you like to be together with Crow?
Here, I'm going to let you have a moment.
The story of Crow and Ritty Lung seems to be at the heart of the problem here. When relationships break down because of the clash between the duty of tradition and the pressure of the modern way of life.
You know, this is a time of transition. People are beginning to see that perhaps the old ways don't work quite so well in this modern era, particularly perhaps in urban areas.
I'd hate to see the matrilineal system swept away just because in the modern world it can't be made to work for men. It's my last day in Shillong, and I've been invited to dinner at the inspector's home to meet her eldest son, David, and the youngest daughter, Rosabel, the family's next cat door.
At last I get to meet you.
Hello.
I'm Kate.
She's in the middle of her final exams at university.
I've come to help. Chop.
Her ambition is to become a judge.
Here are the onions.
Here are the onions. Okay. Now you see, this is already surprising me that David is the one that's in charge of the cooking. Is this always true?
Yes, it's true.
Don't as long as he's saying it's true, I have to agree with him.
Don't hesitate.
Yes, it's true.
As a member of the new generation that's been educated and brought up in a modern city, it's great to get Rosabel's perspective on what she sees as the future of Kasi life.
The fields are very dirty.
How much you think your ambitions are connected to the fact that not only do you have an extraordinary mother and you've been very lucky to have an education, but also that you come from the Kasi tradition?
I don't think if I was born in some other part of India, I would even have the courage of aiming so high and of... I don't even think I would have the courage of expecting people to respect my ambitions, because men respect women in matrilineal society, unlike in other parts.
But do they, though? I've had really mixed experiences. You know, I've seen both sides. Well, I mean, your mum's story.
I'm sorry, I have to interrupt. That's enough, kid.
That's enough, okay.
Yes, that's enough.
I mean, it doesn't make you immune from some of the awful things that can happen. And equally, I've heard from, you know, from some men that they feel somehow that they don't have a role. And in a funny sort of way, that is, or they would say, that's why they're more disrespectful to women.
If we don't make it flexible, if we don't let people know that there are rooms for improvement and there is a scope for change, the caste tradition will face the crisis of passing into oblivion, the threat of being substituted by a patrilineal society. Mm. So making it flexible is very important.
Mm. She's right. Mm. I agree with what she said. It doesn't need to be a patrilineal society to take up responsibility. Once you're a father, you have a responsibility over for your children, for your wife, for your family, for everybody.
And what improvements would you make? How do you think the system could be adapted to make it work in a more sophisticated urban environment like Shillong?
In order to avoid friction and to make men, at least the male children, feel that they have an equal status in society, the parents would distribute their property maybe equally, or not give everything to just one person, mm-hmm. but give everybody equal share.
While the family agrees it's important to adapt the system and share the wealth amongst the children, Rosabelle's still adamant that they should hold on to one key aspect of it.
I don't think the children should take the surname of the fathers, because in that way, if this whole system will be converted to, if we'll do away with it and just bring in the patrilineal system, then there the crisis will emerge where the matrilineal society will pass into oblivion. What makes us different from all the people in the entire country, what makes the northeastern part different, is the very fact that we have the matrilineal society, and I'm very, very proud of it. I don't think we should change the passing of surname, but just adjustments when it comes to inheritance of property.
It's done.
It's done?
Yes.
It's a really clean, lovely smell. You know, you get the smell of the pepper, you get the smell of the ginger, you get the smell of the chili. You can smell all those lovely individual flavours. Mm. Okay, and sit down.
Be careful, it's hot.
Thank you.
So, the moment of truth.
The moment of truth.
That's delicious. That's really...
She's just being nice.
And honestly...
No, I don't doubt his cooking.
And did your mother teach you this dish?
Yes.
That's another thing you've done, Inspector. How do you do it? You control all the traffic in Shillong, you have the most amazing children, and you teach them to cook.
Mimi? Shim shim mam shafi.
It's lovely.
That is so good, and it's spicy.
Mm. But lovely spicy, isn't it? It's a really clean...
It's really good. I should start learning.
I think you should start learning.
Over my time here, equality is a word that's come back again and again. Yes, there are problems here, like in most societies, and the pressures of tradition and duty weigh heavy at times. But despite those very real issues, it does feel that overall, this is a fairer place for both men and women. They are a very kind of forward-thinking people, and everybody from Balung and Shito in the village through to the extraordinary Rosabelle, the inspector's younger daughter, they all understand that, you know, things are changing and the matrilineal system is going to need to change too. It doesn't mean that the women here are immune from
abandonment by husbands or immune from domestic abuse or indeed any of the things that can be inflicted on women anywhere else in the world. But it does mean that they have a sense of self-assurance and confidence. And when you come to a country where that is quite unusual, you realize that that is a very positive thing. So maybe we should look at this place, one of the last remaining matrilineal societies in the world, and learn from it about what can happen when you give women independence and instill in them a strong sense of worth. When you have empowered women, you have a society that feels a lot fairer, that feels like it works better. And surely, surely that can only be a good thing.
A high-flying businessman's determined to show his worth in the workplace after a stroke changed his life. See how he gets on at 9 on Monday as Employable Me returns to BBC Two. And next, Odious and Odorous. It could only be QI.